What's up, Sneaky Nation? Sneaky P here, back with week one of our Columbus Aviators franchise as the Aviators are looking to take flight here in their season opener in their brand new city against their division rival, the Jacksonville Jaguars. Rookie coach Ryan Mack is looking to take this Aviator team to the next level, but it's going to be a tough test early on as the Jaguars were the division winners last season. Now, our division really wasn't all that great. They actually finished with the same record as we did. However, they did have a few tiebreakers on us, and that gave them the wild card position anyway. But Marcus Mariota and company are looking to turn the tables on Blake Bortles this season. We've added a lot of weapons on offense as well as defense. And even though some of our guys are a little bit younger, we definitely feel like we have a lot of playmakers in place to take this team to the next level. Let's go ahead and get ready to kick things off here. Greg the Leg, now with the Jaguars, is going to get us underway. And this one is going to Owusu, who's going to field this on about the 4-yard line. He takes it up past the 15, 20, 25, still on his feet, up to the 31-yard line. A great return from Chris Owusu there, who was not in the return game last year, but he's looking to make an impact there this year next to the rookie Sean Sutton. Marcus Mariota running out onto the field now. We didn't see a whole lot of him in preseason. We are mostly looking for a backup, but he had a great rookie season for us last year, looking to take that second stage here in his second year. Bishop Sankey gets things going for the Aviators on the left side with a 9-yard run. Sankey up the middle. He has a first down to the 47-yard line. Mariota looking to pass for the first time today, and he's going to overthrow his target there, making it 2nd and 10 on the left side. Delaney Walker, the reliable tight end, across midfield to the 48-yard line of Jaguar territory. On the right side, this is the rookie, Curtis Hardin. He avoids the tackles into the end zone. Touchdown for the Columbus Aviators. The rookie wide receiver showing off his speed here early with his new team, and that is a 48-yard touchdown pass. Puzlesny is not happy. That will bring out Blake Bortles for the first time this season. Again, the young quarterback won the division last year. He's looking to make a good impact this year as he hands it off to Robert Turbin. A good addition here on the left side. Turbin's going to pick up 3. 2nd and 7 now over the middle. David Osbury up to the 30-yard line. A gain of about 7. Play action. Bortles pressure coming. And Arakpo is going to get the sack. This is a much improved defense with the addition of Nada. And that should open up holes for other players to make plays, as you see Arakpo making one there. And nowhere for Turbin to go. Pressure coming again, and Bortles going down again. The defensive line putting all kinds of pressure on the quarterback there with the linebackers. Obviously, a 2-yard loss, 2nd and 12. Pressure coming. Mariota avoids the sack on the left side. He connects with Wayne Chapman, the rookie tight end. 3rd and 8 now over the middle, and Brown is going to get the interception for the Jaguars. A poor throw there from Mariota. He actually had an open target there, but missed the throw completely, thrown behind him. And that's going to set the Jaguars up with great field position as Turbin on the left side has about a 14-yard gain there. 1st and 10, Turbin again on a roll all the way down to the 38-yard line, a 12-yard run. That's going to bring in Denard Robinson going up the middle, and they're having some success running the ball here this drive. 3rd and 4 over the middle, David Osbury reaching out and making a great catch down to the 15-yard line. 1st and 10, Bortles is going down again. That is the rookie Tyrone Stevens getting the sack, the cornerback there, and Blackman cannot hold on to this one. It is going to be 3rd and long for the Jaguars. Play action, Bortles over the middle, and Allen Hurns is coming down with it at the 3-yard line. A great play from Hurns there to hold on to the ball. Nowhere for Turbin to go. 2nd and goal from the 3-yard line. Bortles, time to work with. And on the right side, he's going to connect with Allen Hurns. Touchdown for the Jacksonville Jaguars. We have a tie ball game here. 7-7. Hurns looking to make a big impact for the Jaguars this year, and they respond early. So both teams scoring here early on. Here comes the kickoff. This is the rookie Sean Sutton fielding this on about the 6-yard line, past the 20, 25, 30. Turns on the burners. He is going up the field and returns it all the way to the 45-yard line. That is exactly why we signed him. We saw the big play potential, and he is showing us good there as Doran Dickerson runs for 6, 2nd and 4. On the right side, almost intercepted by the Jaguars there. 3rd and 4 for the Aviators. On the left side, a screenplay to David Cobb. He has a first down and more all the way to about the 35-yard line. Line 13-yard play there. 1st and 10, play action, pressure coming. Mariota barely getting the ball out of his hands there. This time a pitch, and Bishop Sankey has nowhere to go, losing 4 on the play, making it 3rd and 14 over the middle. Delaney Walker has a reception. It's not going to be enough for a first down, but it's good enough to put the rookie kicker Johnson in field goal range, and he will knock it right through the uprights. 10-7 is going to be the score here. About 1.5 minutes to go in the first. Turbin on the left side now. is going to pick up about 5 yards, second and five. Bortles on the right side, a dangerous throw, and Dre Kirkpatrick has the interception, the 10-5 touchdown for the Columbus Aviators. Dre Kirkpatrick jumped the route, and there was nobody that was going to catch him in that situation. He puts the Aviators up 17-7. He was kind of a controversial signing there, and it looks like the ball slipped out of Bortles' hands. It definitely did not look like a clean pass, and Dre Kirkpatrick is going to make him pay with a pick six. Our defense stepping up big time there, and that is exactly what we wanted to see from them this season. Start making more plays. We didn't get a lot of interceptions from them last year. First and 10, pressure coming, and Bortles is going down again. Arakpo once more. Bortles barely getting the ball out of his hands here. He is not having time to do anything in the pocket today. Third and 21 again, pressure coming, and he is going to throw this ball away wisely. Blake Bortles not getting any help from his offensive line here today. As Sankey breaks one tackle, it's not going to matter, though. He is going to lose three on the play. Second and 13, Mariota on the right side looking to scramble, avoids one tackle, and he has a first down at the 35-yard line, a 14-yard run, but Mariota is down with an injury. This was our worst fear coming into this season, is our backup quarterback play, and we are going to have to see what our rookie can do here. Patrick handed it off there the first time, second and 10 on the left side to Laney Walker. That's good for about 4 yards. Patrick making it work there. It's going to be third and six, though, and he's going to need to step up and make a play. Patrick, pressure coming, and it's going to be a conservative screen play to David Cobb. That's good for a first down, and Mariota has returned from injury. So it's nice to see our backup quarterback step up, go 2 of 2 right there. Second and 5, Mariota on the left side connects with Justin Hunter across the 40-yard line down to about the 35. First and 10, Mariota on the right side this time. Bishop Sankey going to pick up about 2 yards, second and 8, a pitch to Sankey this time. He has some room to work with, only one defender to beat here. The 5 touchdown for Bishop Sankey, a 33-yard touchdown run. It definitely, oh, that was a terrible spike, Sankey. Come on now. Come on, you're taking all the momentum out of the throw there. Definitely looked like he was going to get caught instead. Bishop Sankey making the play happen. 24-7 is going to be the score there. A nice run from the Jaguars up to the 41. Now Osbury breaking some tackles, and he has a first down across midfield to the 48-yard line. First and 10, Bortles connects with Robinson down to the 42. Second and 4. Now Bortles over the middle. Robinson again going to take it down to about the 34-yard line. An 8-yard gain. Play action. Bortles pressure coming. He gets the ball away, and that is Tyrone Stevens swatting the ball away there. The rookie cornerback making a great play. Play action again. Second and 10. Bortles on the right side. A guy's coming for him, and he throws the ball away. He does not have much time to make good decisions here. Third and 10. Bortles going deep this time, and they are going to get a penalty on Tyrone Stevens, the rookie cornerback, on a defensive pass interference. That's going to open things up for Robert Turbin's 1 yard run there. And the Jaguars have gotten back up onto the board here. 14-24 is going to be the score. A little over 7 minutes to go here before halftime. Not a good play from the rookie cornerback. He's made some other good plays earlier, including a swatted pass a few plays before. But when you give him a touchdown like that, you know, it's very, very costly. He's just going to have to learn as the season progresses. This is Harden on the right side. Good for about 12 yards. First and 10. Sankey on the left side this time. Picking up about 7 there. Second and 3. Mariota pressure coming. A screenplay to Dexter McCluster. And he is going to have a first down up to the 46-yard line of Jaguar territory. First and 10 on the right side. Curtis Harden has a first down catch to about the 33-yard line. Good for 13 yards. Now Doran Dickerson up the middle. But we are getting a holding call on the play. This one is coming back, and it'll be first and 18. Play action. Mariota rolling out on the right side. Intercepted by Demetrius McCray. A horrible read there from Marcus Mariota. And the cornerback from Appalachian State is going to make him pay and give the Jaguars great field position here with a chance to close this game in a little bit tighter before halftime. They're going to have about 3 minutes to work with. Blake Bortles getting good protection this time, and it'll work out as he will connect with Allen Hurns for a 3-yard gain. Second and 7 on the left side. Hurns again. He is having a big game here today for the Jaguars. Third and 3. David Osbury also having a good game. Makes the first down grab to the 40-yard line. Bortles on the left side. That is going to get swatted away, but once again by Dre Kirkpatrick. Second and 10 on the right side. Osbury, an insane grab there. Only picked up 3, but a great catch. Third and 7 now, and that is an easy first down for the Jaguars as Robinson takes it down to the 24 for an 11-yard gain. First and 10 over the middle. This is Marquise Lee down to the 13-yard line. Under a minute to go now. Bortles gets the throw off. Hurns cannot make the catch there. Second and 10. Bortles connects down to the 6-yard line. Third and two, a big play for the Jaguars, and Osbury has it down to the 1-yard line. First and goal, Robert Turbin runs it in for his second touchdown of the day, and the Jaguars are closing the gap, making this a 3-point game, 24-21. The Aviators are going to run this one into halftime. You know, our offense is looking really good right now, outside of a few turnovers. If we take those turnovers away, I think this score is not near as close as it looks. I feel pretty comfortable with the plays that our offense are making right now. Curtis Harden had a great play for the rookie Bishop Sankey, a 33-yard touchdown run. It's going to be up to our offense to hold on to the ball, not make crucial mistakes, and see if our defense can continue to make some good plays. Looking at the first half stats, you can see the Aviators are dominating. We are back in the second half now. The Jaguars are going to start off with the ball, looking to take the lead here in the second half. 2-yard loss on the run by Turbin there, and pressure on its way once again, and Bortles is going down. Derek Morgan getting the sack for the Aviators this time. Third and 21 play action, pressure on its way, and Bortles cannot do anything. Very lucky to avoid the safety there. Avery Williamson is going to get the sack for the Aviators, and that's going to pin the punter back against the end zone there, and this is the rookie Sean Sutton looking to return the punt here, and he takes it down to the 35-yard line. A very short field for the Aviators here as they hand the ball off to Doran Dickerson. That's good for about a 7-yard gain there. Second and three on the right side. This is Kendall Wright, and he takes it all the way down to the 1-yard line for a 27-yard gain. First and goal for the Aviators, looking to build on this lead, and Sankey is going to take the ball into the end zone. Touchdown for the Aviators. That will put them up by two possessions now, as the score is going to be 31-21. And play action, Bortles on the right side overthrows this one. Pressure once again getting to him. The Aviators have been throwing a lot of blitzes the Jaguars way, and the offensive line is not able to contain it very well. Third and five now. Bortles again under pressure on the left side. He is going to find his target, but it is going to be a dropped pass, and that is a huge blow to the Jaguars, as that has sucked away a lot of momentum as Doran Dickerson breaks one free all the way down to the 45-yard line of Jaguar territory. A short field once again for the Aviators as Marcus Mariota slides down after a 6-yard gain. Second and four on the left side. Doriel Green Beckham takes it down to the 33-yard line for a first down. First and 10. Sankey on the outside. A little spin move to gain some extra room there, and he is going to pick up 8 on the run. Second and two on the left side. This is Delaney Walker all the way down to about the 14-yard line. An 11-yard play. First and 10 now. And screenplay did not work. Second and 13. Mariota scanning the field on the left side. He's going to look for the rookie Harden, and he cannot hold on to the ball. Third and 13 now on the right side. Harden does hold on to the ball this time. It's a 10-yard gain, but with the loss earlier, it's not enough for a first, as Mason Johnson's going to come in and kick a field goal right through the uprights. 34-21 is going to be the score. It's still a two-possession game, and the Jaguars are going to have to start making plays on offense if they want a chance of getting back into this game. Second and 9. That's not going to work. Turbin fumbles the ball. He jumps right back on it, though. It's going to be third and long here for the Jaguars, and Bortles needs to deliver a big play, and Osbury cannot hold on to it. Once again, Tyrone Stevens, the rookie cornerback, is going to knock the pass out of his hands. He is really showing to be a great pickup here, as the other rookie, Curtis Harden, takes it all the way to the 23-yard line on left side. Doyle Green Beckham cannot hold on to the ball there. Second and 10. Mariota, time to work with on the left side. He will connect with Curtis Harden down to about the 5 or 7 yard line here. He broke a tackle. First and goal. Mariota on the right side. Kendall Wright takes it to the 2-yard line for a 5-yard gain. Second and goal. Mariota looking. He's thinking about scrambling. Instead, he throws it to Wayne Chapman, the rookie tight end. And now he is going to make a play. The story of the day are the Columbus Aviator rookie players, all of which are stepping up, making some huge plays for the team here. And they're going to have a 40-21 lead. And for the two-point conversion, Mariota runs it in. That's going to make it a three-possession game, 42-21. Again, the Columbus Aviator rookies stepping up big time here, as well as our pass rush. We have been over Bortles all game long. He's going to complete that one for about 11 yards to the 31-yard line. Osbury on the right side going to pick up about 5 second and five. Turbin going up the middle this time. It's going to be third and short here, third and one to be specific. And this is Lonnie Pryor, good for a first down of the 46-yard line. First and 10, Turbin again on the left side, going to gain about three more. Second and 7, Turbin once more, and he is going to be just shy of that first down mark. Third and short again, third and 2. Bortles on the right side, over, throws his target big time. They're going to go for it on fourth down. Turbin avoids one tackle. He will not avoid the other two. Speaking of rookies, this is McElroy making the play for the Aviators, and that will be a turnover on downs. And once again, a short field for this Aviator offense. Their defense has done a great job of putting them in very good positions to succeed, and the offense has been putting points up on the board. It's not going to work here as they punt the ball away. And Turbin going to break one tackle, will not break another as he loses 2 yards there. Second and 12, Lonnie Pryor on the right side gains those back in. More on a 5-yard run there. Third and 7, Bortles from the end zone going to connect with David Osbury up to the 19-yard line. An 11-yard play there. Bortles again on the right side coming back for the ball. That is a first down to the 34. First and 10 over the middle. Blackman cannot hold on there. Second and 10, Bortles. Pressure coming, and he is going down. That is Nada, the free agent, signing, making the play. The Jaguars' offensive line letting their quarterback down big time as he airs one out on the left side, and this is almost intercepted. Once again, Blackman not able to make a play, and the Aviators will take back over as Sankey runs for 4. Second and 6, Sankey again on the left side, picking up 5. Third and 1, Sankey third time's the charm as he has a first down to the 32-yard line, a gain of 3. Now Doran Dickerson, who's had a pretty big game for the Aviators, going to have a 6-yard run. Now Dexter McCluster coming into the game as the Aviators are just looking to run this clock out. This time they'll do a play action on the right side, and Wayne Chapman gets held by Dwayne Gratz there. That definitely would have been completion. Instead, it's a pass interference, and the Aviators will have a first down as Sankey takes it on the left side. A great run up to the 36-yard line of Jaguar territory. McCluster this time going to pick up about 3 second and 7 play action. Mariota airing it out on the right side, going to connect with Justin Hunter. That's down to about the 21-yard line for 12 yards. Sankey on the left side gets tripped up and going to lose about 3 there. Second and 13, Sankey again going down. It's going to be third and 14 here for the Aviators. Mariota on the right side. Delaney Walker cannot hold on to the ball, and Mason Johnson will kick his third field goal of the game right through the uprights. 45-21 is going to be the score. The Aviators continue to put points up on the board here, and the Jaguars just going through the motions at this point. Only 3.5 minutes to go. Alan Hearn's going to make a reception there. That's good for about 4 yards. Second and 6. Bortles, pressure coming. He will get the ball off. Blackman, once again, not able to hold onto the ball there. He has been letting this Jaguars offense down. This time he does deliver an 8-yard play for a first down as Alan Hearn's again makes another reception up to the 37 for 7 yards. Second and 3 over the middle. This is Kelly, and he's going to have a first down to the 42. First and 10, Bortles on the left side, getting into some kind of rhythm, even though it's too late, as Blackman has an 8-yard catch there. Second and 2, this one is going to get swatted away. Once again, Dre Kirkpatrick making the play there. Second or third and 2 here, and he gets pushed out of bounds. They're going to say he caught it inbounds, though, and now Bortles fumbles the ball, and Arakpo jumps on it. That is going to be the game. It was over anyway, but that'll put it into the Jaguars' final grasp. Bad a drive there. Bortles fumbling the ball out of sack. It could not be more fitting as the Aviators defense just put a lot of pressure on Bortles all day. We seriously blitzed the majority of this game. Once we figured out the Jaguars offensive line wasn't able to hold strong enough to give Bortles the time to make some plays, we wanted to exploit that. So we kept putting pressure on him, and once again he's going to cough up the ball there. Once again he made a mistake. Now he hadn't been making a whole lot of like turnovers there. But he really didn't have a whole lot of time to make decisions today. And the Aviators are going to win their first game as the Columbus Aviators in their brand new city. And they did it in fashion, not allowing a single point scored in the second half. And we put up 45 points. You know, we definitely gave our home crowd a show. Dre Kirkpatrick was huge in his Aviator debut officially. As you can see, we pretty much dominated the whole game. The Jaguars offense really could not get into any kind of rhythm here. Let's check out the stats. Mariota, 20 of 28, 236 yards. Not a whole lot of yards for Mariota considering that we put up 45 points up on the board. But we had a short field a lot of the time to work with. Blake Bortles, 26 of 42 for 214 yards. Kerry Patrick came in and made 2 completions. Definitely good job filling in for Mariota when he went down. 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions for Mariota. Blake Bortles, 1 touchdown, 1 interception. Running the ball, Bishop Sankey, 23 carries, 108 yards, 2 touchdowns for him. Robert Turbin, 17 carries, only 48 yards. He did get 2 touchdowns. He also fumbled the ball once, but really could not get into any kind of rhythm. Dickerson had a great game. Lonnie Pryor had a pretty good game there as well. So the fullback's definitely getting involved. And then we saw Mariota scramble once or twice there for a big gain. That fumble by Turbin, though. Receiving the ball, David Osbury was everywhere. 9 catches, 72 yards for him. Allen Hurns, the third-year pro from Miami, with 6 catches, 38 yards, and a touchdown for him. Curtis Hardin, the 6'4 rookie from UCLA, 6 catches, 124 yards, and a touchdown. We saw on the Aviators' very first drive the plays he is capable of making. The guy is a burner, and he provides us a weapon I don't know that I've ever had on a franchise mode before. He definitely seems like the real deal early on. One issue that we did have, though, is we didn't really get Doriel Green Beckham as involved as I would have liked there. You see, Wayne Chapman had 2 catches, good for a touchdown as well. So both rookie receivers there, one tight end, one actual wide receiver, stepping up and making some plays. Justin Blackman, I feel like he had more drops than that. You know, Tyrone Stevens, outside of that pass interference in the end zone, he really had a phenomenal game for this team. In fact, the entire Aviator defense played great. You know, a lot of the Jaguars' points came based off the Aviators' turnovers in the first half there. And I definitely feel comfortable. Look at this. 2 sacks for Avery Williamson, 1.5 for Nada, 1.5 for Arakpo, Derek Morgan getting a sack, Tyrone Stevens, who had a monster game, getting a sack as well. And then you have Daquan Jones and Casey each sharing a sack. Unbelievable performance from the Aviators. I think that totaled, I forget, I counted before. Dre Kirkpatrick with an interception, Sergio Brown with an interception, and Appalachian State alum Demetrius McCray also making a play there. Fumbles forced, Avery Williamson forcing a fumble there. Fumbles recovered, Brian Arakpo making the play, and the Aviators are going to escape with a 45-21 victory over their division rivals, starting the season off right. However, this was a home game. We won a lot of home games last year. Our real test is coming next week on the road as we take on the Indianapolis Colts. Is this Aviator team going to show up, or the same one we saw in road games last year? I'll see you next time.